Alright, let's see updates for Codex. Which part is new? The part on top? Yeah, even with Gordon off the force, there are still good people at the precinct. Montoya's one of them. It was Waller who told me that I'd need allies going undercover, but I'm glad I still have a few at the GCPD. I've known Detective Montoya long enough to be confident that she'll pick up where Gordon left off. She won't stop fighting until the pact is secure in Blackgate Prison. John Doe? Without John's quick thinking and his willingness to attack Bane, I might have died at the Black Site. The pack turned on me as soon as my intention to destroy the virus became clear. John alone stood by me, fighting by my side, even at the risk of Harley's wrath. While his actions were heroic, I've started to wonder how much self-interest played a role. Before entering the lab, John confided in me that he didn't want Harley to get her hands on the virus, afraid that if she did, she'd abandon him. Which was exactly what happened. John's in a dark place right now, but if there's one thing I've learned about him, it's his unfailing ability to bounce back after disaster. If he can help me locate Harley, maybe he can get some closure on their relationship. Maybe this was exactly the impetus he needed to see the light and straighten out his life. Avesta was already on edge at Sanctus, a place she called the darkest part of the agency's history. So Waller's orders to stay away from Freeze, our best lead, didn't set well with her. Avesta suspected Waller didn't want us to hear about the virus's secondary properties and wanted to know why. That made two of us. In the PAX headquarters, we got our answer, or the closest we can get to one. All evidence pointed to the agency having taken the last of Riddler's blood. And if that was the case, we realized the agency alone would have control of the serum. Avesta's nervous what Waller might do with that power. She decided to find the remaining blood samples, in spite of the punishment she'll face if she fails. I admit it's a bold move, but I respect her tenacity. If anyone could succeed, it's her. Every time I think I have Waller figured out, I learn something new that forces me to reassess. Waller wants the virus secured. She said she'll use Sanctus's technology for good. But even Agent Avesta, who respects and trusts Waller, is nervous what Waller may do if she controls both the virus and the serum. Worse, it seems like Waller is the only voice of law enforcement left in the city. She fired Gordon for disobeying orders and jeopardizing my undercover mission, but perhaps those were just convenient excuses to cover up her real motive. For now, our goals still align. We both want to find Harley and the virus. There's no point burning any bridges yet. Deceased. I recovered more details of Riddler's past from the Sanctus computer networks. It's intriguing stuff, to say the least. Impressed with his criminal history and ambitious vision, the agency offered Riddler a fortune to work in their science and intelligence units. He exceeded expectations and was soon promoted to work in Sanctus, the shadow arm of the clandestine organization. Riddler helped advance their genetic engineering and biomechanical weaponization projects, earning him a solid status within the agency. Among these projects was Lotus, a deadly virus that they believe could be altered to enhance the body's natural regenerative properties. Lotus's potential encouraged the agency to sanction human experimentation. But after several failed trials, enthusiasm for Lotus had diminished. In a final and desperate round of experimentation, Riddler was accidentally dosed with Lotus. He and his colleagues assumed he would die within days, but he survived. He is the only human known to have done so. Over time, he began to exhibit the signs of growth they had been searching for. This turned Riddler into yet another of Sanctus's research subjects. His fellow scientists attempted to subject him to painful and horrific experimentation. However, Riddler eventually escaped Sanctus and the agency, swearing revenge on an organization that once promised him a future. So yeah, he literally did become a living riddle. Got a few more things. Oh, quite a few. Hold on 1 second, guys. Okay. I left Selina at the Pack's mercy. It was the only way to maintain my cover. They threw her in one of Riddler's murder boxes, and we left for the black site. She broke out, no thanks to me. I found the murder box empty when I returned to the subway. It was a huge relief, but a simple apology isn't going to make up for this one. Yeah, I still feel bad about that. It's possible I may never get the chance to apologize anyway. Selena's probably out of town by now, not looking back. Harley wants me dead after my betrayal at the black site. She may still try to come after me, but right now her priority seems to be escaping with the virus. Harley was at the lair. She disappeared before I showed up. John said she came looking for Riddler's blood, but the agency already had it. She took her anger out on John and bolted. Harley's still out there with the virus, and John's my only lead. Gotham's fate lies in the hands of an emotionally distraught, drunken ex-Arkham inmate pursuing his violent ex-girlfriend. I may need to find a plan B. Last I saw Freeze, he was in a Sanctus airlock, infected with the virus. Eager for my help, he explained that the virus's secondary properties and his hopes that, like Riddler, he might survive. He's convinced Nora, his wife, could also benefit by the serum. As a show of good faith, he gave me a lead on Harley. In exchange for this information, he asked me to turn down the temperature in his airlock. This would further slow the virus's spread and make it difficult for the agency to experiment on him. I complied. Couldn't they just raise it again? If he survives, Freeze's gratitude may come in handy down the road. If he doesn't, it was still the right thing to do. Bane is finally in agency custody after the assault on Sanctus, along with most of his soldiers. He nearly killed me at the black site, failing only because of John's interference. With the pact dissolved and Bane out of the picture, I can focus on the last remaining threat, Harley. The Gotham City Police Department won't be the same without Gordon in charge. He had a tough time cleaning it up when he was first promoted. Let's hope his absence doesn't reverse that progress. Sanctus. There was some truth in Riddler's claim that the agency made him. Riddler used to work for Sanctus, and during that time, became infected with the virus. Unlike previous test subjects, though, Riddler didn't die a horrible death. Somehow he survived. He became stronger. Sanctus went underground after the agency tried to shut them down, but even with their continued research, Sanctus never discovered the potential healing properties of the virus. That was Riddler's secret, and his curse. And lastly, Bodhi Spa. I was able to prevent some bloodshed at Bodhi Spa, but at a steep price. I had to betray Selena to the pact. At least I found the murder box in the lair empty. Alright. So what do we have? Examine Lotus? Examine Bioscan.
The Bioscan of Riddler's body. I used the analysis you sent me to simulate its interaction with the virus. And the Batcomputer promptly found holes in Freeze's calculations.
Okay. And the Lotus?
Lotus. Megavirus. Only one known survivor. Riddler. Freeze thinks his blood is now a key to unlocking Lotus's true potential. It appears that Lotus can be synthesized into a restorative agent for the human body. A remarkable one.
Well, Freeze got that part right, but...
But as soon as Lotus repairs any physical problems, it causes irreparable damage to the subject's brain chemistry.
It drives you insane.
It's what Riddler meant when he said, "I wasn't always like this."
All of these people, all of them trying to kill each other, but something that will make them as deranged as he was in the end. We all should know by now that miracles come with a cost. Lotus is nothing more than a poison.
I think Riddler would
enjoy
this.
Something tells me Riddler would be laughing at all this. It's all such a mess.
One madman begetting more. He would have reveled in it.
Run the simulation again. Then forward the readings to Special Agent Iman Avesta.
I already ran it several times myself. I wanted to be thorough. Silly notion, I know. My problems are purely psychological. My real cure is a very long vacation. Somewhere far away from Gotham. A place where the sun actually comes to visit.
I might come with you.
I might even come with you after all this is over.
Well, I shall hold you to that.
Ah.
But you can't bring your bat suit.
I can't. Oh, that's just calling.
I read your report. The serum makes the whole thing beyond dangerous.
Did you find out where Waller's keeping Riddler's blood?
Yeah. She's got the area on lockdown, but I think I can get myself in. And then I'm taking these things off the table. Permanently.
Kick some butt. Just be careful.
Agreed. But be careful.
It shouldn't be a problem. I'm trusted here. I won't let Waller turn the agency back into something like Sanctus, Bruce. The vials have to go.
Good luck.
Yep, good luck.
Let's get you somewhere more comfortable.
Oh, Bruce. Tiffany's up there. She's probably wondering where I hurried off to.
In the mansion?
I'm sorry, Albert. We can't risk you falling again.
Very well.
You need...
Oh, we mustn't keep Tiffany worrying any longer.
In your wheelchair?
She's done quite enough of that the past few days.
Ready?
Alright. Oopsie daisy.
I'm afraid that's all we do. Worry the ones closest to us.
I thought you meant say oopsie daisy. I get old really quick saying oopsie daisy all the time.
Okay, yes, thank you. The doctor is on her way. How are you feeling?
Well, better. A little more rest and some tea, and I'll be as good as new.
He wants tea, huh?
Make that a lot more rest, Alfred. You're hurt.
The only thing hurt is my pride, which, sadly, even the doctor won't be able to fix.
You can put up a strong front, but I'm not leaving your side until the doctor arrives. Got it?
Aww.
Understood.
Be straight with me. How worried should I be? You don't need to sugarcoat it. I just need facts.
Let him tell you.
I'll let Alfred tell you himself.
I told you, I'm fine.
Okay, never mind, I'll tell
sorry,
you.
Sorry, it's just... There's a lot more to worry about right now than me.
So... Bruce. After our little talk at your office, I had an idea.
Oh, yeah?
There's something I want to show you.
Oh, goody. See something.
So... I've been working on this in my spare time. I remember you said you could use the help, you know, when you're Batman.
Huh.
I started thinking about a tactical suit, in case I'm ever needed in the field.
You want to be Robin?
Para-aramid synthetic lining.
Batgirl?
Photo-adaptive suit coloring. Full-spectrum, full-surround heads-up display. I should be able to get the mesh fabricated in no time.
What did it say? I was pressing those and nothing happened.
I'm getting ahead of myself. The last thing you want is me out there on the rooftops with you.
Well, that'd be cool, though.
This wasn't all just about me. You've been going up against some heavy opposition, Bruce.
Yeah.
More than usual. Alfred told me how Bane nearly killed you.
Didn't break my
so
back.
So I designed you this.
What you got? Oh,
that's a gun.
I don't use guns.
Let me read you the specs.
Batman doesn't use guns, Tiffany.
You mean at all?
Pretty much.
I guess I've never seen you use one. But I didn't realize that was, like, a rule.
Batman doesn't kill.
I don't use a gun because Batman doesn't kill.
Okay, I get it.
A relationship changed?
Still, criminals are always trying to kill Batman.
I don't want a relationship change.
Are you telling me you've never once considered a gun? Just to even the odds?
Of course I have.
It's a no-brainer.
Of course I think about it sometimes. It'd be the easiest thing in the world.
But easy doesn't make it right.
Yep.
Bingo.
Listen, I should have thought it through more. I just got so caught up in the design, I didn't... I have a lot left to learn.
Don't be so hard on yourself.
Can we be nice to her, or is she just going to sit in there saying nothing? John says found Harley. I guess he's saying nothing to her. A complete jerk. All right. The old Bonus Bros Carnival, outskirts of town. Better hurry.
I have to go.
We'll be waiting right here.
Aw. Can we say something to reassure her? He said he was a complete jerk. Nice. Bonus Brothers Carnival, 11:28 p.m. It's getting late. It's time for our nighty night. Go sheepy. What's it say? Oh, funhouse. I thought it said unhouse. Unhouse me, you lout. Oh. This is bound to be interesting.
John?
This is right up his alley. Test your might. Who put the thing through the head here? Tea party? Jack in the box? Boo-boos. Yeah, I literally did just that. Looked at it. Oh, that's pretty devilish looking. We gotta do it. Watch it kill him. Oh, I gotta do this?
Broken.
Oh. All of a sudden it pops up. Alright, this is creepy. Lab coat? John, cut it out.
Dr. Quinzel.
Oh.
This is Harley's.
Keep the thing as a souvenir. Before I go that way, let's see if there's anything else to see. Oh, test of strength.
Test your might.
Mortal Kombat! Large Marge. Just tell him Large Marge sent you. Swing away, Bruce. What? Up and down? E? I'm a sick duck? Damn it. Piece of crap. Alright. Nothing else to look at in here, then, so we're entering. With just a little apprehension. Now, here comes your doom. Ha. Ha. Can't go back. Oh, the painting makes sounds like that? Oh, okay. Nah. Almost cut out. Ha. Ha. Something tells me this has been altered somewhat. Oh! Are you kidding me? That scared me. Punch it. Alright. Jump scares. This isn't even the Walking Dead one. Not that the Walking Dead's usually scary. That one was okay. What's it say? To the hangman? You lost. John, get a grip on yourself. Did he find his true self again? Because I wonder what's going on with that. Okay, this is making me dizzy. Oh, yeah, it's making me dizzy because it's pairing back.
Oh, God, please. They're not making this easy on me, you know?
You're talking to me?
I couldn't say to Bruce.
Oh.
It wasn't me. I mean, it was me, but it was self-defense. I know it needs work. Stop judging me.
Are you talking to the voices in his head?
Agents. You should never have come here.
Other agents?
It's about boundaries, you know? This place, it was special to me and Harley. She came here to hide from people like you. And you rudely show up, uninvited? You were uninvited, weren't you? But how do I know? Bruce didn't send you after me. He's so buddy-buddy with the agency. No! Bruce wouldn't do that! It was like this when I showed up.
I don't want to interrupt him.
Think, John! Think!
Yeah, think, John. It's always a good thing. Oh, there he is.
Bruce?
Yeah, sometimes.
I'm so glad you're here.
When I'm not the other bee person.
Please, it's not what it looks like.
Oh, so what is it then?
I can explain. Just try and reserve judgment.
It's okay, just calm down.
Take a deep breath, John. Just calm down.
It was horrible. Just horrible. But you're right. I should do my exercises. Get a hold of myself.
Yeah. That's your exercises?
What happened? Is Harley here?
She left just as I got here. The agents, they came looking for her. They're not supposed to just start shooting, Bruce. They're supposed to say, hands up! I've seen it on the TV.
Hollywood.
They just attacked you.
I tried to talk sense into them, but they wouldn't listen. They just wanted blood. Something took hold of me. Something dark and vicious and desperate for survival. I grabbed the nearest thing and started swinging.
You think this is funny?
I'm sorry. I always laugh when I'm nervous.
He does. He laughs for other things too, though. What's this? Turn the lights off? Or on?
Wow. I completely redecorated, didn't I?
Yeah, I saw that.
I wonder what Harley would think of the new color scheme.
You're not nervous now. Well, that's how other agents...
You said you hit them with something.
I think so. I just grabbed whatever came to hand.
This woman has a gunshot wound.
Oh, really?
In the back.
Oh, yeah, it's coming back to me now. She was going for her partner's gun, and I just went on autopilot. I didn't stop until I was safe. I've just been sitting here in the dark until you came in.
Just be straight with me.
You can be straight with me, John.
Why wouldn't I be telling you the truth?
I don't know.
If I hadn't fought them off, I'd be the one lying in a pool of blood. You believed me.
How'd you take down them all?
Because we don't have trust. What do we really have?
You don't have powers. How do you take them all down?
It's the foundation of any healthy relationship.
Of course I trust you.
Of course it is that. Of course I do.
Then what's with all the suspicion?
You're
just trying to tell me what you think I want to hear.
Oh, is that why I clicked that?
You're supposed to be on my side!
I am on your side, John.
I guess I'm an
idiot for expecting that, aren't I?
Oh, come on, John.
What do you mean?
Whatever this is between us, it's off balance.
It's a bromance.
The goodwill only flows one way, and it isn't towards me. You've made that very clear by now.
You're imagining
John,
things.
John, that's not true, okay? You're imagining things.
Really? Loopy old John's hearing the voices again. Is that it?
Well, you were just
you really
talking
know
to you,
how to stick the knife in, Bruce.
Oh, God.
I should have known things were wrong the moment you put that tracker on me.
I don't think there's
you
anything I can say.
You were using me from the start. At least have the decency to admit it. The least you can do is what's clean about that.
Yeah.
I'm not stupid, Bruce.
He wouldn't believe us, right? If we say it's not
please,
true.
Please, please. Don't feed me any more lies.
I have been
okay. Maybe I have been using you. I'm sorry.
You already
John,
knew it.
There's more at stake here than your feelings.
It's like Dr. Leland always said, never demean another person's emotions.
Uh-oh. Cue.
John, I'm...
I could have had you. But for that sucker punch, didn't think Batman fought dirty like that.
Oh, he knows?
You forget I know you, Bruce. The real